Fast, long serve, just like yesterday. She started with two yesterday. These are as fast as they come. Right near her baseline, right to the wide corner of Chun Meng as well. And a dismissive shot as Mima Ito turns, looking for that forehand on the backhand corner. Chun Meng with a good answer. Goes out to the wide forehand. It's going to put a little hesitation in the step of the fast-footed Mima Ito.
Let 1-0.
Now this is the effect of a flat hit. It comes back in the bottom of the net. Those are the Mima fans right there. Japanese style signs. A taste of her own medicine, handles the receive. Handles the serve with the receive, I should say, but Chun Meng with a good third ball. Right back to where it came from, deep into the corner. Saying two can play that game. I'm staying close. Stay right near the table. Oh, corner to corner, the forehand there to finish. Now remember, Mima Ito, spinnier on the forehand side, at least she can be, but she's capable of these quick, flat hits, just a little bit of topspin. That one is perfectly to the corner. Now in the midst of Mima Ito's just dominating spree, 2018 Japan and Sweden. I remember that right after dominating Team China, Mima Ito has mom watches on and practice partner as well, Coach Matsu's younger brother of 10 years, her sparring partner. Right at the baseline of the table though. I was gonna say, I forgot what I was gonna say. Oh yes, Duhoi Kim in Austria the week after this amazing victory in Sweden. Duhoi Kim comes out and beats Mima Ito in the early rounds, spinning it to the baseline. Chop block, but it's played right into the elbow. Chun Meng in the middle. Five of the first eight so far. Chun Meng makes it look easy, but she reads the spin perfectly. Ma Lin, up on his feet. Maybe Ma Long too, if he's watching at home right now.
3-6.
And when you play someone who plays such flat shots, these laser-like shots without the arc of the spin, keeping it deep on the table, keeping it low, these are two very effective tactics. Wow, a net to finish it. This is a lot of footwork for Chun Meng. Gets her steps in this rally. Nearly dizzying, a chop from Mima Ito, then a chop block. And when she starts attacking, Chun Meng's way behind, but then the drop shot, and a little fortune there for the 23-year-old. Seems crazy to say, considering at 14 we saw her taking major events. 2-point lead here for Chun Meng. Good pressure keeps the spin on. Now I mentioned deep on the table and I mentioned low, but that extra topspin is also gonna help. It's gonna make the ball accelerate away from the net. Try to drive Mima Ito behind the table. You will rarely see Mima Ito more than a step behind the table in this match. Keeping the weight forward on top of every bounce. Bringing the score line to back within two. Remember, she's been handcuffed. Chun Meng has completely figured out Mima Ito, at least that's how it would seem based on their history. Just to add to that point, They've played twice this year. Chun Meng hasn't dropped a game. 3-0 and 4-0 in a best of seven. The last time Mima Ito won a game was before the pandemic in 2020. And that was a 4-1 victory for Chun Meng. She gets it back. The net from earlier, fair trade. No animals were harmed in the making of this point. So the last 8 points, Chun Meng has won 75% of, six of the last eight. Good variation in the spin. And Mima Ito's full of variation. From the flat hitting shots to chop blocks to a variety of serves. No fear of using side spin in the rally. We've already seen that since the start of this game.
Net 9-6.
Tight half-long serve, low to the net, and Chun Meng with four game points to take the first. Clever idea for Mima-chan. It's always going to be tough, those aggressive, flatter shots. But a kicking long serve right into the elbow saves a game point. Three more to go, Mima with one more serve. This one to the backhand side, both on the body, catching the edge. This one goes sailing away. Look at that. If the ball could sing, I think we know what song it would be singing right now. Chun Meng with 12% more success on her service than Mima Ito, winning 62% of her points when she serves. She's got two game points. Oh, and it catches the net on the way over, 11-8, Chun Meng really shot off the racket and seemed to win her the point. But the success rate was higher for Chun Meng on her serve, setting up a third ball, winning points when she serves. It's not about necessarily winning the point with the serve on its own. Good angle on this one. Climbs the net and comes over, so she acknowledges her fortune. Right to the edge, good deep push. One small step for someone tall, two giant steps for Mima-chan.
Let love to. Long three.
Not a point on the scoreboard yet. Service game. What can Mima-chan do to surprise? Well, from 6-10 in the last game, those long serves into the elbow were both effective, just slightly on either side. The idea is right. She's taking her chances, and sometimes that's what has to happen. When you're 0-6 against somebody, you haven't won a game in your last two encounters. It's been 3 years since the last time you won a game. More than that, you have to try something new. Chun Meng's game is stable, it is quality, it is very well-rounded. She's got a strong base, she's compact, she's efficient, she reads the opponent well. Mima's game is very tricky, very dangerous.
Let 4-1.
But is it as stable? Well, you have to imagine that behind closed doors, the Chinese national team prepared very hard for Mima Ito's game after 2018. And a good fast long serve to that backhand corner. Which means that if Mima's gonna use the backhand, she's not gonna have as much spin. So she wants to step around for the forehand. And even still, there's a lot of pressure to make that shot quality after leaving the whole table open. It's the Mima smash, the forehand attack that is fast and flat, but it also means that it's a lower percentage shot. It doesn't arc up to clear the net and then dive back down because of the topspin. Much the opposite, less topspin, more of a laser-like trajectory.
7-1.
It's interesting, you rarely see players falling forward. Don't see players falling too much at all, but in terms of balance, that's how important it is for Mima Ito to stay close to the table. Clever idea, but the long push comes back with quality topspin from Chun Meng. It's almost crazy to me that Chun Meng is able to make such a quality shot and get back into position so quickly. This is where the core muscles and the balance come into play.
1-9.
For years and years on the internet, you can find videos of the women of the Chinese national team doing different exercises for balance, strength, and conditioning.
Let 1-9.
8 points down here. Two serves for Mima Chan now.
And
she just makes it look so easy. Chun Meng picks her place on the table. Goes to the deep backhand corner. Top spin and placement. She's got 9 game points. Ah, a bit of a break here off the top of the net. Still a good rally. A few impressive shots come back into play. This wouldn't be easy even with a coach on your bench. For Mima Ito, doing a lot of searching on her own, trying to figure out what it will take. Tough to say if anyone would really have the answers. Going for her shots, but the heavy topspin coming in protects, and Chun Meng.
Long one.
Fan Ying with, I'd say, the best percentage of any chopper in the world against Chinese opponents. I think she's got a 16% career win rate against Team China. Beautiful reach over that back corner of the table. It's a very difficult place to get around the ball. So 14 of the last 16 for Chun Meng. And she keeps it going. And a timeout here. Minori actually played herself. You can find her if you go on the head-to-head stats for ITTF. One of my favorite things to look up to see how players pair off, how they stand. Well, since the timeout, nothing has quite worked out for Mima Ito looking for answers. Top of the net and just out. That one really trampolined off the net. Goes to show you how tight the net is here. Generally, that keeps the ball in play. Because it's right near the net post, there's a little bit more tension there. The farther from the net post you get, the less tension there is. The ball won't quite spring off as much.
6-1.
Closer example, or a good example, I should say. Just 1 point on the scoreboard for Mima Ito. There it is, quick. When she warms up, you can watch her the first 2 minutes before a match. When she plays this shot, it's like the Bruce Lee punch. That's why I call it the Mima punch. This one a little bit more follow through and acceleration, but in her warm-ups, she recoils so quickly. It's like a thumb prick, just snaps. But a steady stroke here as Chun Meng spins it to the baseline once again. Doesn't look phased. Pretty much on autopilot here and everything working out for Chun Meng.
Leto. 2-7.
little help off the top of the net, but they've both been playing low and had their fair share. Feels fairly balanced to me. And a fast long serve to the forehand. Remember, Mima loves to step around the backhand because, well, the forehand side of a racket generates more spin. So stepping around gives her a little more security, at least on the opening attack. Good touch play on both sides. A little bit of hot potato here. Where did it all begin? Nice push, opens up the rally. Basically finishes the rally. Soft hands from Mima-chan to keep the ball in play from baseline at the table in a tough situation. Ah!
4-9.
Mima's got serves that are a little bit different than everybody else's. Sometimes a bit of a tomahawk and a timeout now for Chun Meng. Service game strong.
9-5.
The tomahawk, how Mima does it, nobody else does it quite like that. Low toss, heavy rotation. What exact rotation was on it? So Chun Meng up even higher, 72% service success, and Mima Ito just about half, just over half. The touch play,
9-6.
Yeah, 37, so half of 74 if you'd like. But Chun Meng at 72. Anyway, Mima Ito winning several outright points. See a lot of people wearing the same necklace as Mima Ito in Japan. Big point there, Chun Meng. The difference between having four match points and having serious momentum and only 2 points between them. But it is four match points for Chun Meng. And there it is, Chun Meng 3-0 without dropping a game, 11-6.